Would you please welcome Makur Maker? Thank you so much for coming in. We're really sorry that our studio team has lowered your seats, literally as low as it goes. And you're fresh off the court, aren't you?
Yeah, not too long ago. Had a game at 2:45 today. It was a loss, but...
Well, it wasn't what we've been on a bit of a streak, so we weren't expecting to be talking about a loss tonight.
Definitely. But I've had a great time with the Kings. It's been great. These 13-win streak, great coaches, Coach Chase Buford. The Kings have been doing a great job with me.
So you've picked up your American accent. When you went to the States, you were the 16th selection in the draft, a bit like being in the top five in Australian rules or rugby league and so on. So you're obviously a major choice. You decided to go to a university that didn't have a background for basketball at all. In fact, it has a background in Washington of research. Was that a political statement? Were you trying to say something there and going there as against a basketball university?
You know, I always think that it's great to protest, but I felt like for my voice to be heard, and it had to be heard, was with all the turmoil going on in the States, you know, in 2020, the George Floyd killing, like you guys saw, you know, social unrest, you know, in this day and age, you see everything on social media, which I felt like, you know, making an impact was going to Howard. And I think most of the stuff that's happening today is because, you know, a lot of people are uneducated on people's backgrounds.
So you deliberately decided that...
I deliberately decided. I said, you know, I thought one time, you know, how can I make an impact?
Yeah.
And I think by doing that was going to Howard University. And then I think it did start a ripple effect. You see the NBA All-Star and stuff like that. You know, everything's changing and people know what HBCU now, I guess.
What did your mum and dad say? Obviously, it would have been easier to, you know, go to a university where you just go straight into the professional leagues and make lots of money.
Yeah, I could have went to, you know, my top final four was UCLA, Kentucky.
Wow.
Howard. Kansas. I was considering Kansas also because my coach was, you know, very close to Bill Self. But
you'd be playing in the American League now, probably, if you'd done that.
Yeah, I'd probably play in the NBA, but you never know, you know?
You wouldn't be here, that's for sure.
No, you never know. With the COVID year, it ruined a lot of plans, you know? I wish I had my season at Howard, but there's only so much you can control. But, you know, it's only so much you can control.
So because of COVID, you guys weren't playing at Howard. That wasn't happening, right?
I got a chance to play a couple games, but COVID, you know, affected my teammates and, you know, in a very bad way. So our season had to get shut down.
So usually you'd be being seen by all of the people who are choosing players for the NBA, and that's what really upset your trajectory.
Yeah, it's kind of tough because it was very unexpected. You know, we had plans to play, you know, high-level teams also. But due to COVID, you know, things got changed and, you know, not a lot of fans at games. So it was just kind of weird year for everybody, you know, not just me by myself. So a lot of people were affected.
And, I mean, was basketball always the dream? Or do you grow up to be almost 7 foot tall and you're like, well, I guess that's what I'm doing?
No, it wasn't always a dream. Actually, when I was younger, I wanted to play soccer. So, I wanted to be a soccer player. I saw myself being like Cristiano Ronaldo, to be honest. But
a tall version.
But a taller version, yeah, definitely. But, you know, I started off, you know, running track and field also at a school called St. Andrews in Perth, Australia. But after that, I grew very tall and I got better at basketball at a rapid pace, so I decided to play basketball.
Did you think of Aussie rules?
AFL a little bit. I played a couple of games. You know, I enjoy being the rocker and stuff like that.
And what was your background? You came from South Sudan through the refugee camps in Kenya to Australia, so?
No, I left home, you know, South Sudan and Kenya, where I was born, Nairobi, Kenya.
Yeah.
You know, I left there when I was 11 months. So, and I got a chance to visit back in 2013, but, and then I came to Australia in Perth, and that's where my family and I grew up with my brothers and sisters and my mom and dad.
So you're playing for the Sydney Kings now. There are rumours swirling around, crazy rumours, that LeBron James' son, Bronny James, might be joining the Sydney Kings. Is that a live rumour that's got some substance behind it?
I'd say if he was considering coming to the NBL, go to the Sydney Kings. You know, we're the best team in the league.
Well, it has been delightful to meet you, Makur Maker. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Long Game, Bigger Than Basketball, premieres this Friday, 22nd April on Apple TV+. It is incredible and it's worth a watch as well.
Thanks so much for joining us.